Education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about find the value of n and r in combination. What could be our objectives? First, we will find the number of combination of n objects taking r at a time. Second, we will solve for the value of n or r in combinations. What is a combination? It is a selection made from a group of items without regard to their order. The number of combinations of n things taking r at a time is given by the formula combination of n objects taking r at a time equals n factorial all over the quantity n minus r factorial times r factorial, where n is the number of objects, r is the number of objects you want to select, exclamation, that could be the factorial. In example number 1, let us find combination of 8 objects taken 5 at a time. So what could be the given? N that is equal to 8, and then R that is equal to 5. We may use the formula for the combination of n objects taking r at a time equals n factorial all over the quantity n minus r factorial times r factorial. So the value of n that is equal to 8, the value of r that is equal to 5. We may replace n and r to the given equation. So n that is equal to 8 factorial and then the quantity n that is equal to 8 minus r that is equal to 5 and then factorial. R that is equal to 5 factorial. So let us solve. Combination of 8 objects taken 5 at a time, it is equal to, copy the numerator 8 factorial, 8 minus 5 that is 3 factorial, and then copy 5 factorial. So we may multiply 8 times 7 times 6 up to 5 factorial to cancel 5 factorial in the denominator. So the factored form of 3 factorial, that is 3 times 2 times 1. 5 factorial retained because our factored form of 8 factorial, 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 factorial only to cancel 5 factorial in the denominator. Because 5 factorial, the equivalent is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And then 3 times 2, that is equal to 6. So cancel 6 in the numerator. So let us solve. Combination of 8 objects taken 5 at a time, that is equal to 8 times 7, the answer is equal to 56. In example number 2, find R if combination of 7 objects taking R at a time, it is equal to 35. Let us find the value of R. N that is equal to 7, and then combination of 7 objects taking r at a time, it is equal to 35. It is not possible to use the formula. So let us find the value of n. First, multiply n, so this is n, with the next number, next lower number or numbers. Sample, 7 times 6. So let us multiply. 7 times 6, the answer is equal to 42. Second step, divide by the value of combination of n objects taking r at a time. Combination of 7 objects taking r at a time, it is equal to 35. So 42 divided by 35, the answer is equal to 1.2. But then, the quotient cannot be transformed in factorial form. So by trial and error, repeat step 1 again. So 7 times 6 times 5. So multiply n with the next lower numbers. 7 times 6 times 5, the answer is equal to 110. Second step, divide by the value of combination. So 210 divided by 35, the answer is equal to 6. So the quotient is 6. that can be transformed in factorial form because the factor of 6 is equal to 3 times 2 times 1. And the factorial form of 3 times 2 times 1, the answer is equal to 3 factorial. So it means R, it is equal to 3. So let us check if the answer is correct if R is equal to 3. Combination of 7 objects taking 3 at a time, n is equal to 7, R is equal to 3. So let us replace. Combination of 7 objects taking 3 at a time, that is equal to 35, equals n, that is equal to 7 factorial, n, that is 7, minus R, that is equal to 3, factorial, and then R, that is equal to 3 factorial. 7 minus 3, the answer is equal to 4 factorial, copy 35, copy 7 factorial, copy 3 factorial. And then, copy 35, and then distribute 7 factorial up to 4 factorial only to cancel 4 factorial in the denominator. So it means 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial. And then the 3 factorial, that is 3 times 2, and 3 times 2, that is equal to 6. Cancel 4 factorial, and then let us solve. So cancel 6. 7 times 5, the answer is equal to 35. As you can see, combination of 7 objects taking 3 at a time, it is equal to 35 equals 35. How about example number 3? Find R if combination of 14 objects taking R at a time, it is equal to 91. Let us find R. So N, that is equal to 14, and combination of 14 objects taking R at a time, it is equal to 91. So what could be the solution? It is not easy to use the formula, so let us find the value of N. First, multiply N with the next lower number or number. So this N, lower number to 14, that is equal to 13. And then afterwards, let us multiply. 14 times 13, the answer is equal to 182. Second step, divide by the value of combination of n objects taking R at a time. So 182 divided by 91, the answer is equal to 2. Third step, find the quotient that can be transformed in factorial form. 2 can be transformed in a factorial form. 2, that is equal to 2 times 1. So 2 times 1, that is equal to 2 factorial. So it means R, it is equal to 2. How about number 4? Find N if the combination of N objects taking 3 at a time, it is equal to 35. So let us find N. So what could be the given? R, that is equal to 3, and then combination of n objects taking 3 at a time, it is equal to 35. Again, it is not easy to use the formula because the unknown is n. So what could be the solution? So let us find the value of n. First, expand the factorial form based in the value of R. R is equal to 3, so the factorial form, that is n, times n minus 1 times n minus 2. Second, divide by the factorial of R. So R, that is equal to 3. So divide all by 3 factorial. Next, equal to the value of combination of n objects taking R at a time over 1. So combination of n objects taking 3 at a time, it is equal to 35. So 35 divided by 1. So let us solve. N times n minus 1 times n minus 2, and then the 3 factorial, that is 3 times 2 times 1, the answer is equal to 6. And then copy 35, copy 1. Multiply both sides by 6, so it means cancel 6 on the left side. So this means n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 equals 35 times 6, the answer is equal to 210. Or we cross-multiply. 1 times n is n. 1 times n minus 1 is n minus 1. 1 times n minus 2 is n minus 2. And then 6 times 35, the answer is equal to 210. Think a factor of 210 that is 3 consecutive in descending order. So the possible factor is 7 times 6 times 5, that is equal to 210. It is not possible 6 times 5 times 4 because that is not equal to 210. So let us proceed. N, that is equal to 7. So N equals 7. Second one, N minus 1, that is equal to 6. So let us solve for the value of N, negative 1 going to right. N is also equal to 7. N minus 2 equals 5. So negative 2 going to right, change the sign. So 5 plus 2, N is also equal to 7. So the value of N is equal to 7. In example number 5, find N if combination of N objects taken 4 at a time, it is equal to 70. So let us find the value of N if the value of R, that is equal to 4, and then the combination of N objects taking 4 at a time, that is equal to 70. So it is not possible to use the formula for the combination because N is unknown. So let us first find the value of N. First step, expand the factorial form based in the value of R. If the value of R is 4, so the factorial form, it should be 4. So N times N minus 1 times N minus 2 times N minus 3. Second step, divide by the factorial of R. R, that is equal to 4. So it means divide by 4 factorial. Third step, equal to the value of the combination of N objects taking R at a time over 1. And the value of combination of N objects taking 4 at a time, that is equal to 70. So equals 70 over 1. And then let us distribute or what could be the value of the 4 factorial. So the value of the 4 factorial, that is equal to 24. Afterwards, let us multiply both sides with 24. If we multiply both sides by 24, so it means on the left side, n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 times n minus 3 equals 70 times 24. The answer is equal to 1,680. And then afterwards, copy on the left side n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 times n minus 3. And the factored form of 1,680, it should be 4 consecutive. The 4 consecutive in descending order, that is 8 times 7 times 6 times 5. If we multiply, the answer is equal to 1,680. It is not possible 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 because that is not equal to 1,680. So let us proceed. N first, that is equal to 8. If we try the second one, N minus 1, that is equal to 7. 7 plus 1, the answer is also equal to 8. And then the third, N minus 2, that is equal to 6. 6 plus 2, N is equal to 8. And then the last, N minus 3 is equal to 5. 5 plus 3, the answer is also equal to 8. So it means the value of N is equal to 8. Instruction, calculate each of the following. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.